Okay, so you've reached the end of this Docker Fundamentals course. Firstly, congratulations. You should know that the knowledge you've gained, both theory and practical, is going to benefit you as you move through your career. But you might be asking yourself, what's next? What's the next logical step that you should take? Well, let's explore that. Now, this course has been an introductory level to Docker. The course is called Docker Fundamentals, and so it's only a minor part of all of the knowledge in the Docker ecosystem. Depending on when you're watching this course, I'm either busy producing some deeper dives into Docker, or I already have those courses. It's my intention that this course is a foundation, and I'm going to be building ever more complex courses over the top of this, diving ever deeper into the Docker ecosystem. Alternatively, you might like to try some other related topics, such as Kubernetes. And again, depending on when you're watching this course, I might already have some Kubernetes courses. It's my intention to start off with a Kubernetes Fundamentals course, but as with Docker, I'll be making more complex courses over the next few months. Another option is that you might like to apply your new container knowledge to AWS. I have a full range of paid AWS courses covering both how to use the platforms in the real world and AWS certification. And all of these courses are available on my school website, which is on screen now and linked attached to this video. Alternatively, you might like to apply your container knowledge but to a different cloud platform, such as Azure. And while I don't make any Azure courses, I do have a strong recommendation, and that's learn.cloudly.io. Just to reiterate, these courses aren't created by me, but they do look to have a good, solid quality. So if you want to take advantage of your container knowledge and move across to use this with a cloud platform such as Azure, then this is a really good school to check out in case you're interested in that platform. Now, you might want to improve your knowledge, but instead of focusing on theory and architecture, you might want to look at skills more practically. And if that's the case, I do have a repo with lots of free mini projects. At the moment, these are focused mainly on AWS, but there are some more generic mini projects in there, such as container-based mini projects, and I am rapidly expanding this repository with lots of different technical mini projects. So definitely check this out. And then lastly, I want to draw attention to what I think is one of the best resources that you can use to continue your learning journey and get into this space from a job perspective, and that's the learning community, techstudyslack.com. Now, this community is focused on learning. It has lots of different channels covering different technical areas such as AWS, Google, Azure, and then other things like Terraform, containers such as Docker and Kubernetes, and much more. It has lots of study group channels if you're studying for particular certifications, but it also has channels dedicated to helping you get a job. Now, I always say that when you're learning, the best thing that you can do is surround yourself with people both on the same journey and people who have more skill than you. So this is a really good resource. Now, I do think it's really important that you do have a learning plan. So think about the types of roles that you want in 1, 2, 3, and 5 years. Look at the skills required for those roles. Do a gap analysis between where you are now and what you need for those roles, and then build a study plan. If you do want to study in any of the areas which I've mentioned, then I really would love if you use another of my courses as part of your learning journey. Now, at this point, that is everything I wanted to cover on this topic. Once again, above all, I wanted to say thank you. Thank you for taking the time to watch my course, and thank you in advance if you decide to take any of my future courses. If you liked this course, then also thanks for any recommendations that you can provide. As a solo creator, word of mouth is the only way that I can grow and help more people. So if you did enjoy yourself in this course, then please tell everyone all about it. Tell friends, work colleagues, and post about it on social media. Everything helps as a solo creator. Your recommendations make a massive difference. At this point, though, for the last time in this course, we're all done, so go ahead and complete the video, and I hope to see you soon in another course.